Hey guys, I'm Nigel from TechieDIY, and in this video, I'm going to show you how I made an LED fidget spinner. Spinners are something to play or fidget with instead of clicking your pen or biting your fingernails. They're surprisingly addictive, and sometimes they help you concentrate. The basic construction is a case or holder with a bearing in the centre, and I decided to make a wooden one which has a nice tactile feel and incorporate LEDs into it to make it a bit different. So to start with, I created a design using Google SketchUp and then used that to create a cutting and drilling template. If you want to build one yourself, you can find all the links and information in the video description. The parts that I used are a piece of wood, two fast flashing coloured LEDs. These work on 3 volts and cycle through a range of colours. And to power them, I'm using 2 coin batteries and battery holders. I also used a bearing with rubber covers, and finally a stainless steel bolt and 2 dome nuts. The first task was to create the wooden housing. I set the table saw to 40mm and cut the wood to width. Then I squared the end of the wood on the mitre saw, measured 90mm, and then cut the wood to length. Next, I glued the paper template onto the wood using a glue stick, marked the centre of the 3 holes, and drilled pilot holes. To cut the holes for the battery connectors, I used a 25mm diameter Forstner drill bit, and I drilled down to a depth of 7.5mm. I used a 22mm diameter spade bit to cut the hole in the center to accept the bearing, but didn't cut all the way through the wood. Instead, I stopped a couple of millimetres short. And then from the rear, I cut a 20mm diameter hole, which left a ledge for the bearing to sit against. Then I swapped over to a step drill and drilled 6mm diameter holes for the LEDs, finishing the holes with a countersink drill bit. To cut out the shape, I used an inverted jigsaw. The battery holders have an offset rectangular section, so I drew around one. And then used a chisel to cut out the marked area. I removed the paper template, then rounded the edges using a roundover bit installed in the router table. Sanded the wood until it was smooth, and finished it off with a coat of lacquer. The next task was to solder the LEDs to the battery holders. The long lead on the LED is soldered to the positive side of the battery holder and the short lead to the negative side. The LED is located directly below the hole in the base of the battery holder, rather than centrally between the solder terminals. I put a small piece of heat shrink tubing on the short LED lead to identify it, and then bent it over with some thin nose pliers. I also bent over the long LED lead, and then placing the LED over the hole in the battery holder, I bent the long lead around the positive terminal. The short LED lead was then bent around the negative terminal, and both leads were soldered in place. tops of the terminals were removed with cutters. And before final assembly, I tested the LEDs were working. Once both LEDs were soldered, I hot glued them into the wooden holder. To enable the spinner to spin faster, I cleaned the grease out of the bearing. To do that, I removed the rubber seals by levering them out with a screwdriver. And then I sprayed WD-40 into the bearing until all the grease was removed. The rubber seals were then also cleaned and replaced. The next task was to cut off the bolt head. I did this by clamping it into a vise and cutting it off with a hacksaw. I then filed away the rough edges with a file. The screw thread was then inserted through the bearing and the two dome nuts screwed onto either end. And finally, the bearing was glued into the wooden holder. I gave it a quick spin to check that everything was okay. And then inserted the batteries. To turn the LEDs off, I just insert some thin plastic strips underneath the battery contacts. So that's the spinner completed. I think it worked out pretty well, but please leave a comment and let me know what you think, or anything else in fact, like where you're viewing from, I'd love to know. If you did like the video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you do want to see more videos like this, then please subscribe. Remember to click on the bell button to adjust your notifications. Finally, please check out the video description for the links to this project. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again next time.